Hey guys, we're on to our second lesson of women's rights, and today we're going to be looking at the differences between the different types of groups that existed who were pushing for rights, and they did that in different ways. So examining today the different ways they tried to get their rights is going to be important for our story. And so what I've got you guys to start with is just a quick little task, which I hope you'll get a small scrap of paper or a post-it note, or if you want to turn to the back of your books, then that's great as well. And all I want you to do is I'm going to disappear, and I want you guys, I'm going to flash the information up on the screen, and all I want you to do is give 10 or 20 points, depending on if you've picked the first option or the second option, and we're trying to add up at the end the points that you guys get. And all they are, they're going to be just simple opinion statements I want you to come up with, and I want you to add up your score at the end. I will explain why we're doing this at the end, but for now, here's your first statement. You feel strongly about an issue, and it can be any issue you want, but you want others to listen to your thoughts. What do you do? Do you try to persuade others to listen to your viewpoint? Okay. Or do you get maximum publicity for your cause by making sure everything you do is written down in the press, in the newspapers? Go ahead and give yourselves a score. Okay, 3, 2, 1. All right, the next one. There's 5 in total, but the second one says, you want MPs to listen to your cause. How do you get members of parliament to do that? Well, do you 10 points, talk to the MPs and send petitions so they know that you're serious? Do you send like letters and applications to them? Or do you harass them and enter the House of Commons, into Parliament, disrupt public and private meetings so they're forced to listen to you? All right, pick your choice. 3, 2, 1. Okay, next one. Number 3, you want those who live far away to know about your beliefs. How are you going to do this? Do you distribute letters, leaflets, posters, hold public meetings with guest speakers, 10 points? Or do you, for 20, do you grab someone's attention, making headlines by smashing windows, chaining yourself to things? Which one do you do? Okay, are you going to go for the leaflets and posters, or are you going to smash some windows? 3, 2, 1. Number 4 of 5. Someone fighting for your cause dies. How do you react? Well, you can not make a big deal. The person was unpredictable and caused more harm than good. Or do you treat this person like a martyr, a hero, organizing a huge public funeral to highlight the cause? What are you going to do? Okay, 3, 2, 1. And the last one, MPs have broken a promise to you and they've changed their mind on a law they were meant to pass. What do you do? Do you carry on peacefully, protesting and hoping that they will change their minds? Or do you use violent methods like burning down buildings to make them regret their decision? Have a read and decide. Okay, 3, 2, 1. Right. So welcome back. What I'd like you to do now quickly is add up your points, please. Add up the points you gave. Okay, can you spend a second now? You can pause the video until you do that. That's fine. But please, can you add up your points? And when you're ready, we're going to move on. I think that's probably enough time now. If you haven't, pause the video and do it. But we're moving on. Right, so why did I do this activity with you? Well, if you scored 60 or less points, then you might be interested in joining a group of women's rights movement called the Suffragists, created in 1897 by Millicent Fawcett. They organized speeches across the UK. They did petitions to Parliament. They tried to speak using peaceful methods. And that was the whole point of that movement. And so that might be you. This is Millicent Fawcett here. You can see her right there. And these people are out. They're trying to get votes by just making people aware of their cause. If, however, you scored 70 points and above, if that's you, then you might be part of the Suffragettes. And the Jets were different from the Gists, because in the Jets, they were set up in 1903 because this lady here on the left, you can see her here, called Emmeline Pankhurst, she decided the Gists weren't getting the job done. And so she created her own movement, which got called the Suffragists by newspapers as a way of making fun, but they sort of embraced it. And they used violent militant methods to do it. When I say militant, I mean things, anything to do with aggression. We'll look at that keyword in a moment. But they tended to get arrested. They tended to get beaten up. It was pretty horrific. But those are the two groups we're going to be studying today, the suffragists and the suffragettes. And so that's what we're going to be doing. But let's start off as we always do. Can you please pause the video in a second now and write the title? What made the suffragettes different from the suffragists? What was the difference between them? Write the title down. And there's a definition here, a key word, militant. And that word militant meaning favoring violent methods to promote your cause. It comes from the word military. Again, very similar, fighting, isn't it? So it's using violent methods. So can you write the title now, please, and pause the video. Okay, so the first thing I'd like you to do, please, is to write down a subtitle. Who were the suffragists? Can you write that down and underline it? And then what I'd like you to do is read through the information that's in this blue box here and this blue box here. So some of the ways they tried to do it. And all I want you to do is, for the suffragists, is to write down three facts about the suffragists and the methods they used. And then try to think in task two, why do you think these methods might actually help get them the vote? Try and think of a few ways that this peaceful method would help them get the votes. Okay, can you pause the video now? Okay, so now we're going to move on from the suffragists, because our main focus of today is this big group, this group called the suffragettes. They're going to be our focus, and what I'd like you to do is similar to the previous bit. I'd like you to put a subtitle, please. Who were the suffragettes? Okay, if you need to pause the video to do that, that's fine. But you need to underline your title as always. And what we're going to be doing is starting off, before I tell you stuff about the suffragettes, you already know a little bit about the fact that they're violent. If the other ones are peaceful, these ones are violent. Obviously, Mr. Hassan, get a grip. But yeah, I'd like you to study the picture that's on this page. This is from the front cover of the Suffragette magazine that they used to write in, like a newspaper, giving news and updates and things. And I'd like you to have a look at that. And again, I'd like you to show that you know what inferencing is. Now, inferencing means making an educated guess based on what's in front of you. And so I'd like you to study the picture. And then I'd like you to write down a couple of things about the picture. So for example, what does it tell you about the suffragettes? What does it tell you about their methods? What does it tell you about the spirit of their campaign? All right. What is it in the picture that tells you that? Okay. I'm going to give you guys, you shouldn't take more than about 3-4 minutes doing this. So you can do that now by pausing the video. Okay. Welcome back. Thanks for having a go at that. I hope you managed to write down a few things. Right. First of all, did you notice, if I move her out of the way, did you notice that she's wearing armor? Why do people wear armor? What does that suggest? Well, she's going on a battle, like a crusade. And what's a crusade? Well, that's a fight for your right, to fight for what you believe in. So does this mean that the suffragettes are going to be violent? Are they going to fight for their rights? Are they willing to die for what they believe? Possibly. She's holding a sword. I mean, that itself is showing that she's willing to use, I mean, she's got it down. She's pointing the sword down. So, of course, that means that she will use violence if needed. She's not coming at you violently, but she will use the sword if she needs to. And she's got that big banner, the WSPU, which stands for the Women's Social and Political Union, nicknamed the Suffragettes. And she poses, if you look at the bottom, she poses a quite striking image, a little bit like Lady Liberty from the French Revolution. Or Joan of Arc, who was a young girl who led French armies against the British to free France from the British who were invading. So again, she resembles that sort of heroic female figure. And that's, I think that's why the suffragettes have chosen that image Again, across the top, it says justice. So they're looking for equality because they feel like justice needs to be done. And until they get their rights, they're not going to be equal. But essentially what it's telling you is that overall, and what you should have written down, is that these women are going to fight for their rights and they're not going to go peacefully. They're willing to fight and die for the cause. So if you want to add that in, that'd be great. And if you want to pause the video to do that, that's fine. But there's some great ideas there. And I hope you managed to get some of them down. Okay, so what I'm going to do now is I'm going to throw a video on for you guys. It's about 4 minutes long. It is the trailer from the film Suffragette. They made a film about it with Meryl Streep and some other great actors and actresses in it. That's always worth a watch if you've got access to it, if it's on one of these platforms. But for now, what I'd like you to do, please, is watch the video, and then we're going to come back to this screen, and we're going to look at these pictures. And all I want you to do is write down, while the video is playing and afterwards as well, what different methods have you noticed them using? So what are these different violent methods that they're using, okay? Right, I'm going to put the video on right now. Here it is.
Women should not exercise judgment in political affairs.
If we allow women to vote, it will mean the loss of social structure.
You work at the laundry?
Part-time from when I was 7, full-time from when I was 12.
We meet Mondays and Thursdays if you're interested.
You a suffragette, Mrs. Elliot?
I consider myself more of a soldier.
As Mrs. Pankhurst says, it's deeds, not words, that will get us the vote.
We've identified weaknesses in their ranks. We're hoping one of them will break.
They're saying she's to speak.
This is a deliberate escalation. This has to stop.
For 50 years, we have labored peacefully to secure the vote for women. We've been ridiculed, battered, and ignored.
Punish those responsible, whatever way you can.
Mama!
All my life, I've done what men told me. Well, I can't have that anymore.
Took my love, took it down.
I incite the women in Britain to rebellion.
Can I sail through the changing ocean tides? Can I handle the seasons of my life?
We break windows. We burn things. Because war's the only language men listen to.
Well, I've been afraid of changing.
There's nothing left but to stop you.
We're in every home, we're half the human race, you can't stop us all.
But time makes you bolder, even
changing. You might lose your life before this is over.
I'm getting older too.
We will win.
I take my love, take it down.
Never surrender. Never give up the fight.
In the snow covered hill.
Okay, that I hope it was useful. So with that video in mind and the four images on this screen, I'd like you to write down, please, some of the methods that you saw, all right? And please feel free now to pause the video in order to do that. Okay, so just to quickly go over some of them, you may have noticed, the picture-wise anyway, you will notice that there's a window there, shop window has been smashed in. You can see that there's a train carriage that's been blown, so they're using bombs to blow up trains. There's a woman there, she's being arrested against the fences of, and that's actually Buckingham Palace. So these women have actually rushed Buckingham Palace to try and break in and speak to the king himself and shout at the king. And these women have been arrested outside Buckingham Palace who are trying to break in. And again, you've got fighting with the police and they're wrestling over a walking stick there, but they're resisting arrest. They're fighting. A lot of women were spitting at the police. And in the video as well, you would have noticed some other things. One of the women blew up a post box. Destroying mail was a way of disrupting just the country from working properly. So there's loads of different methods there, and you're going to find out a few more of those in the next few minutes. Okay, so it's over to you guys now. You're going to find out a little bit more information about just what these suffragettes did. What actions did they actually take then? What are these violent actions? And you're going to look at some specific events. And the best way to do that is obviously to answer some questions once you've read some information. In the spirit of that, what I've done is I have, in the link below, all I want you to do is to have a little look at this document, which you can download. And in this, all it does is it tells you some useful information about the actions they took, and specifically tells you about certain events and certain people that did certain things. So what I'd like you to do is please have a look at that. There's loads of great information there. You've also got access to some of these pictures as well. And really, once you've read that through and you've understood it, all right, all I'd like you to do then is, if I minimize that out of the way, you then return to this, so you can leave this screen on, all right? And that's not a problem at all. And these questions will be here for you. There's five questions on the screen, just some fill in the blank sort of statements. I want you to write them out in full. And then I've got these are the tough ones. These are the thinking further boxes. There are three questions I've put here. Choose four events between 1905 and 1914. So out of all of them, pick four of them. And say why they stand out to you. Describe them, say why they're the most shocking. That's the first question. And that's a good one, because that's really just saying what you think maybe are the most violent, or perhaps they make a big change, or maybe they show them going to the next level. Maybe it's the first of this kind. You decide why you've picked those four to write about in your book. What's so special about those ones? And then the second question on that one is, did the actions of the suffragettes get more or less violent? Well, that's up to you. You need to decide, did they get more or less violent as time went on? Look at the actions, read them again. Really, look at the style of actions. Does it start a certain way, or did it start heavily? You decide whether they get more or less serious, but you need to explain using evidence. Bring some evidence in to say why you think that. And then the third question, do you think these actions actually help the cause, or do they make things worse? Okay, consider both sides. What are the merits of using violence, and what are the bad things about using violence? And perhaps can you see that in some of the evidence you've been reading about on this sheet? I'd like you to do that, please. Have a little look at that. It's going to take you probably about 15 or so, maybe 10 minutes, 10, 15 minutes. So what I'd like you to do is just pause the video and have a go at these tasks now. Okay, I hope you managed to get some good answers down. They're pretty straightforward. The first five questions, the comprehension, pretty straightforward. Really, they're thinking further tasks were really for you, but I really do want to mention that for question two, you will notice that they are getting a lot more violent. It starts off with a bit of window smashing and chaining themselves to fences, to full-on assassination attempts on the Prime Minister, blowing up theatres. I mean, it gets far more violent as time goes on. There's a bigger trend. And of course, they're making a lot more attention on themselves as well, bringing themselves into the public eye. Now, question three, whether you think that they actually helped or not, that's up to you. Obviously, violence, it gets people's attention. It's a big publicity thing. If you make it in the newspapers, it's news for everyone to read about. And the thing is, all news is good news, even if it's bad, because it's good for you, it's publicity. And so on one hand, it is good to get your message out there and what you're asking for. It might also intimidate people into making the decision you want them to make about the law. But on the other side, for question three, you have to think, is violence actually the answer? Is violence going to help your cause? And I draw your attention back to the Chartists, to the meetings and protests, the violence that happened in some of the areas. I draw your attention back to those of you that did work on the Luddites, smashing machines, those of you that look back at Peterloo. Have the government yielded to violence yet? Probably not. In fact, violence is probably one of those things that's going to turn people away from you and make you think that actually you're unreasonable and you're terrorizing rather than actually trying to reason. It's up to you what you think about those. I would be interested when you send your work in to read what you've written about those three questions, especially the thinking further stuff. But let's move on for now. Okay, I have set you some homework because you haven't actually done any homework. It's something that you can do away from here, okay? I will attach the links below. The homework itself is just, you can download the information sheet. It's about the key suffragettes and some of the major ones. So for example, the leader, the bomb maker, the art destroyer, the window smasher, balloon litterer, and the martyr. So they've got character names, but really they did lots of different things. And there's some really interesting things that they did to try and get attention for the cause. And all I want you to do, it's a simple case of just reading the information and answering the questions on the sheet. I'm going to give you guys the question sheet as well that you can download in the link below. It's just going to be called homework. And all it is something that you can do away from this video, and it just stretches your knowledge about some of these key suffragettes, but also goes into a lot more depth about some of the actions that they did. I think that's quite good, especially if you have a go at the challenge questions that are on there. That'll get you thinking as well. So that's something you can do after you finish this work. You can go away and do that, and that should take about sort of 15, 20 minutes. Okay, so what we've got here now is a finishing task. It's a bit of fun, it's a bit of creativity. You shouldn't spend more than 20 minutes on it, and that would complete the lesson time. So I'm going to start off by showing you a video clip from Mary Poppins, actually. She's not in the video clip, but it is a film from Mary Poppins, the mother of the family, Lady Banks. She comes home from a suffragette meeting and she does a song. And there's some great things going on in the video. So I'm going to play that now, and then we're going to discuss it quickly, and then you can go on and do a creative task.
Mrs. Banks, she's home.
Our daughters will adore us, and we'll sing in grateful chorus. Well done, Sister Suffragette.
Good evening, Kate and Helen. Ellen, we had the most glorious meeting. Mrs. Whitburn Allen chained herself to the wheel of the Prime Minister's carriage.
You should have been there.
Mrs. Banks, I would like a word.
And Mrs. Ainslie, she was carried off to prison, singing and scattering pamphlets all the way.
I'm glad you're home, madam. I've always given the best that's in me.
Oh, thank you, Kate and Anna. I always knew you were one of us.
We're clearly soldiers in petty coats and dauntless crusaders for women's votes. Though we adore men individually, we agree that as a group they're rather stupid.
Mrs. Banks!
Cast off the shackles of yesterday, shoulder to shoulder into the fray. Our daughters will adore us, and they'll sing in grateful chorus. Well done, Sister Suffragette.
Be that as it may, I do not wish to offend, but I...
From Kensington to Billingsgate, one hears the restless cries from every corner of the land. Womankind, arise! Political equality and equal rights with men. Take heart, for Mrs. Pankhurst has been clapped in irons again. No more the meek and mild subservience we. We're fighting for our rights militantly. Never you fear!
If I may have a word, Mrs. Banks.
So cast off the shackles of yesterday.
Mrs. Banks!
Shoulder to shoulder into the fray. Our daughters will adore us, and they'll sing in grateful chorus.
Well done, Mrs. Banks!
Well done,
Mrs. Banks!
Well done,
Mrs. Banks!
What is it, Katie?
Okay, so that's a great video. I hope you guys were singing along by the end. I certainly was. Some interesting things came out of that video, okay? So you've got her, she's very fervent, she believes in her cause, and that represents really what a lot of the suffragettes did. They believed heavily. But look at some of these words that they use. Shoulder to shoulder into the fray, you know. What does that mean? What does that mean? Throw off the shackles of yesterday. What does it mean? What are they throwing off? When's yesterday? And daughters. Are we thinking short, long term? Why don't you guys pause the video for about a minute and just have a think about those three statements that I've got in that green box, and then we'll come back and discuss and see if we think the same thing. Okay, let's see if we thought the same thing. Shoulder to shoulder into the fray. What does it mean? Well, of course, it means that they're going to go arm in arm together, a big group of them marching into the fray. When you think about fray, when we say fray, we mean like a battle or a situation, a dangerous situation. So they're going to go together. It means that there's unity. There's going to be togetherness in this cause going into danger. Throw off the shackles of yesterday, another great one. Shackles. When we think of a shackle, we think of something that ties your hands together. Think of those images of slaves with those big iron cuffs on them, you know, and the chain that comes down, linking them together. They're going to throw them off. Again, you know, what is that? Are they physically chained up, these women? No. But what it means is they're going to be free. They're going to get their liberty and independence. When's yesterday? Well, every single day before they get their vote is yesterday, because that represents the past. The past, ever since the past, women have been lower in the food chain than men. They've been treated as less. And so now we're throwing off those shackles, forgetting about yesterday, and we're moving on to tomorrow, a bright future. And of course, this comes in with that quote, daughters, grandchildren. This isn't a change that affects us now. This is for long term. This is for life. Our children are going to be affected. Their children's children will remember what we did here today, the suffragettes are saying. And so that's really important. The suffragette message is long term. It's going to be forever. These changes are going to last forever. Anyway, what I want you guys to do is you've got a choice. You can choose to do activity A or B, number one or two. You can either write your own song about the suffragettes based on everything you found out about the methods they were using, maybe you've been online and done your own research, but have a think about the suffragettes. What would you write as a song for them to chant? Something different, maybe a slogan, maybe a verse. If you just want to come up with a chorus, come up with something that if they were in London today, the suffragettes, what would they be chanting? You know, what kind of things would you be asking them to do? What violent actions? Or the other task is maybe write a speech for Emmeline Pankhurst. We know she's the leader, the founder of this suffragette movement. Well, write a speech for her, no more than 80 words. What should she say? She stands up in front of a crowd and she says, and she reels off this speech, this motivational suffragette unity speech. Well, what are you going to include in that speech? Okay. Don't spend more than sort of like 10, 15 minutes doing this. It's just a bit of fun, just a sort of a bit of creativity to get you guys thinking. And you guys, if you want to go away and find out more about the suffragettes and you want to find out more information, there's some great links. I'm going to include some links in the box below so that you can go away and maybe do some more research if you want to find out more about the suffragettes, so that you can write your song or do your speech more effectively. But as for me, that's the end of the lesson now. Hopefully it's been useful in identifying some of the actions that they were taking and distinguishing between the suffragettes, the violent ones, and the suffragists, who were less violent, more peaceful. Until next time, have a good day and happy history.